Hello everyone, so we'll start module 4, and module 4 deals with memory management and file management. So first we'll see what virtual memory management is. So first topic in module 4 is virtual memory management. So before going to virtual memory, we'll see the background, how your program is executed with the help of memory. So like all the code in the memory need not to be entered or will not be executed once you load your program. Like entire program is not needed for execution. So what we will do, instead of copying complete code into the main memory, partially we will load the program. And at the time of run, with the help of replacement algorithms, what and all we have seen, we will we'll make sure, our operating system will make sure every instruction will be available in main memory only at the time of execution. So for this, like, what is the need of virtual memory here? We know memory management, we have loading algorithms, all those, but why we need virtual memory? So virtual memory is like a separation of user and user logical memory from the physical memory. Here virtual memory is like, for the CPU, it looks all the loaded instructions, means all the instructions will be loaded to the main memory, and it provides a memory address called logical address. So the way that instructions is requested by CPU and the logical address it provides, CPU thinks, or CPU assumes, that there is a memory existing where it is in the order of logical address, and complete code for all the process, whenever it is executing a process, its complete code is loaded. So this is how virtualization of memory is existing. So here we'll see like what is virtual memory. Means virtual address space is a logical view how process is stored in the memory. In the sense, like logical view, in the sense the logical address provided by the CPU, how logical address is provided, in that format we can see the process has stored in the memory. Virtual memory can be implemented via demand paging and demand segmentation. So we have seen paging and segmentation concepts. Based on that, virtual memory can be implemented. So we'll see how actual virtual memory is seen in the computer system. So we all know we have a secondary storage device where the data of process is stored, which is interacted to the physical memory based on the CPU's execution. So we have physical memory based on paging and segmentation. Paging or segmentation, data is loaded to physical memory, and we have memory map. So based on the paging, we use page table with memory mapping, that is our memory mapping unit, or if it is segmentation, we use segment table for memory mapping system. So this is how actual memory management works. But virtual memory is a virtual view of a memory, or logical view of a memory from the CPU, where if the process, like consider a process which has 0 to V number of pages, and it is stored in a chronological in a order. So if a process needs to execute this data, then it provides a logical address, and virtual memory will be stored, like will be assumed, so that the data will be stored in a order and it is fetching the data. So this is a virtual memory. For this virtual memory, to manage virtual memory, this memory management unit will provide data on time, so that virtual memory assumption will be existing in front of CPU. So in the virtual memory address space, unlike our process address space, we have 0 to max where the complete process is stored. So code, data, heap and stack. Code will be having the executable code, data, which is global variables, heap will have the local variables, and stack will contain instructions to be executed. Stack and heap grows based on the execution and changes in the data, addition of data towards, like a heap grows upwards and stack grows downwards, and the center part we call it as hole, which is free space. This is how virtual address space of the virtual memory looks like. Next one is shared libraries using virtual memory. So we all know all the process will share some data, like many processor will can share shared pages or shared data for execution. So in the free memory we have shared library. If you consider two process, process 1 and process 2 is sharing same shared page. So this shared library is sharing the shared pages. Means shared library will have an index to the shared pages which is sharing with, and this process, like one more process, is also having an index address in the free space which is sharing, means which is having a which will have the address space for the shared pages. So this is how virtual memory for shared library looks like. Thank you.